So, you see this rebel over here from Rogue One, the one in the front, the one that the big red arrow is pointing at? Well, this is what my fan fiction is about. You might be wondering, why the hell would you just choose it from a random rebel that was in a scene on Jedha in Rogue One that absolutely means nothing? Well, since this rebel is a prisoner, what if he was taken to the Death Star? And since Rogue One takes place right before the events of A New Hope,
What if he was there on the Death Star during the Battle of Yavin? And what if maybe he was a friend of one of the X-Wing pilots? Let's say he's a friend of Wedge Antilles. Okay, that sounds good. So Wedge wants to go rescue him, and he volunteers to do that considering he's his best friend. But Wedge is told that he can't just go in and abandon the mission to rescue one person. And he'll probably end up dying anyway. So this rebel, he's just sitting there in the Death Star, excited, because he hears about the attack on the Death Star, and he thinks that he's gonna be rescued by a few rebels. He didn't know it was just gonna be entirely in the air. So he's just entirely hopeful. He thinks that he'll be able to be rescued in the next couple of minutes. And since he's experienced so much trauma in the past 3 or 4 days that he's been aboard, he just can't wait to get off there. He's starting to hallucinate. And Wedge, he can't live without this guy. He's his best friend, right? So in this version of A New Hope, in this alternate universe version, Wedge dives right in. He goes through to try and find his friend. He ends up killing a stormtrooper and just completely abandons the mission just to try and find one person. He starts getting calls on his comm link. People are telling him to come back because he's abandoning the mission and that he'll end up dying if he's on there. He starts saying that no, he has to go and do this. So he runs into the chambers disguised as a stormtrooper. Because of his recklessness, he ends up being shot. So in this version, Wedge Antilles is dead and is still in the chamber. And at this point, there's only 5 minutes until the Death Star's in range of Yavin 4. So this guy's getting a bit scared, right? He still thinks they're gonna come for him, but he's not as certain. So we're getting towards the end of the Battle of Yavin now. Luke Skywalker is about to blow up the Death Star. Now, Luke Skywalker is actually always known about this prisoner. There was nothing stopping him from rescuing this guy when he went to rescue Leia, but he didn't. So he really, really missed his opportunity here. But you know what? Luke Skywalker, being that absolutely bloodthirsty man he is, he just doesn't care. He doesn't feel any guilt. So he just goes ahead and does what he ends up doing in the original movie. He just ends up blowing up the Death Star. And that's the end of this fan fiction. I really hope you guys enjoyed. I got the idea from a comment I actually saw on a Star Wars lore video, and it honestly inspired to make this video. So thank you, that guy who commented. So yeah, I just really hope you enjoyed. This was my second fan fiction. I hope I'm getting better at doing fan fictions. I haven't done many of them, but I just really wanted to make a fan fiction off this idea because I thought it would be pretty cool to explore. So that's going to be it for the video. Remember to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.